ako, aminin ko, kami ni Senator Gordon, kami po na hazing. We were subject of hazing. But we are willing to admit it because it's more than 50 years ago. So it has prescribed. hindi na po pwedeng sampahan yung aming mga pati si... But having said that, all right, I will put Nilo here, Dean Divina, in a very difficult position. If you had an opportunity to amend Republic Act 8049, as a active, as a member of a fraternity, inactive as you may be, but being steeped in law, what would you suggest should the amendment be?
Mr. Chairman, I agree that it should be banned completely. There are many ways of determining the resolve of a neophyte to join the fraternity without being subjected to hazing.
So in your view...
It should be completely and totally prohibited or banned, Mr. Chairman.
Hazing or initiation?
Hazing as defined by law, Mr. Chairman, as currently defined by law. But initiation that does not cause psychological harm or injury or physical injury to the neophyte should be allowed, because there are many ways of determining the resolve of a neophyte to join the fraternity.
So you're saying allow initiation but not hazing?
Allow initiation but without subjecting the neophyte to psychological and physical harm or injury, Mr. Chairman.
Alam mo, when we get to that point, it's a dangerous slope. Hindi ba? You know, enforcement of that rule becomes questionable in my mind. And like you, Dean, like Senator Gordon, like Senator Lacson, we all went through this in our younger days. And we know what happens during initiation rites, during the rites when you go through hazing. It is a slippery slope the moment you allow initiation that could lead precisely to incidents, unfortunate incidents such as this.